Bằng khúc ca lên đường, bằng 大天命此乱内路自尊上发生路那里和尊身体要落实恩恩一根松乐便要杀给天外主宰命分红色干此乱内路自家谋在民中中发自文明土中文土后退的人间都替若让谁归荣最迟早先问堂堂
everybody here again. For those of you that haven't been in this ceremony before, you'll notice myself and a few of these other guys that you've seen before are not wearing baseball caps, they're wearing berets. And of course, the Americans always say, well, you have your beret on wrong. No, no, we have our beret on right. We were all advisors with the Vietnamese Airborne Division, which in Vietnamese is Chu Duan Nei Du. And these guys here, which outnumber us, as they always did, are all members, combat veterans of the Vietnamese Airborne Division. And to give you an idea, their division was 11,000 paratroopers, and we were 54 advisors spread out through the division. They were a very tough fighting unit. They may be short in stature, but you don't want to meet one of them in the dark alley. They're tough guys. And we are very proud, we Americans, advisors from Vietnam, that we served with them. And we are very pleased to be here to honor all of our members, the deceased paratroopers of the Vietnamese Airborne Division, the deceased Co Bons, which means advisor in Vietnamese, of that time. So without any further ado, I will post the colors. Color sergeants, post the colors.
Right, left, 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 right
show back porch. Park time. Colors. Halt. And now I'd like to introduce the president of the Jardin Moudeau, which is the family of the Red Berets. Or perhaps I better give you a little more history. When we got reorganized after Vietnam, we advisors organized the Society of the Vietnamese Airborne Division in 1985. Our counterparts, after they got reorganized, after leaving Vietnam, they organized the Family of the Red Beret, or Jardin Moudeau in Vietnamese. So today we have the president of the Jardin Moudeau, who will say a few words. And his name, he's a doctor, his name is Nguyen Quoc Hep. And for those of you that have heard that name, that's not W-I-N, that's N-G-U-Y-E-N, and that's not Nugent, it's Nguyen. So, Dr. Hep.
Once again, my name is Dr. Hep Nguyen. I'm a chairman of the family of Vietnamese Red Beret. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning. Good morning.
During the Vietnam War, Vietnamese paratrooper with the support from the American advisor T-162 and red marker and radio operator, we have been fiercely fought against the North Vietnamese army invaders. What unit have been fighting side by side in many deadly battles, as Tet Offensive in 1972. They are sharing victories as well as losses. Unfortunately, we lost the war due to the political influences. And many, many Vietnamese paratroopers and some generals, they refuse to surrender. They fight their own way to take care of their own life. Ladies and gentlemen, we have so many heroes and many unsung heroes in both Vietnamese and American forces. They are combating the enemy to protect the freedom and the democracy of the South Vietnam. Again, ladies and gentlemen, we are gathering here today to commemorate their heroic sacrifices. And also tomorrow, the Veteran Day. Don't forget to appreciate many, many young, brave American men and women who were on duty in Iraq, Afghanistan, and in any country, many countries around the world, to keep up the peace, protect your land, and promote the human rights. We appreciate them and we salute them. Thank you.
Now I'd like to introduce Colonel Retired Ray Rhodes, who is the President of the Society of the Vietnamese Airborne Division, or AKA the Red Hats. And you can figure out why we call them Red Hats. Ray?
Thank you, Paul.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning.
Xin chào quý vị. We are pleased and honored that you could join us today for the 16th Annual Veterans Day Memorial Ceremony, held jointly by the Society of the Vietnamese Airborne and the family of the Red Berets, Jardin Moudeau. And a very special welcome to the former members of and advisors to the Vietnamese Airborne Division, Chu Duan Nhi Yu, Vietnam Cang Hoa. We have met every year since 2000. Close to Veterans Day, pay tribute to our brothers in arms, American and Vietnamese, who gave their last full measure of devotion on the field of battle in the defense of freedom. At the same time, we also remember our brothers who fell asleep after a whole life of service in their country. remain vividly with us today. It is for those of us, the living, to continue this tradition so that the contributions of our brothers who went on before us will not be forgotten. In this respect, I charge all of us with the responsibility of keeping their memories alive among our families and friends. I suggest those of us who knew and loved these brave airborne soldiers should frequently speak of their exploits when we sit around the table or meet during holidays. I implore each of you to mention them whenever the discussion turns to patriotism and the defense of liberty, equality, and justice. We must strive to keep their memories alive in our hearts and through our witness in the minds of those who did not have the privilege to personally know them. I would say we want to do this in many ways. One way, of course, is to tell those little stories that we know that humanize these brave soldiers and make them real to our families and friends who did not know them. In this way, we will continue to honor our fallen comrades, and they will achieve a small measure of immortality which they truly deserve. Thank you again for participating in today's memorial service. You indeed honor us with your presence. Airborne all the way. Nayu Kogar.
Okay, now invite Dr. Hepp and Colonel Rhodes to uncover the memorial wreath. Sergeant, bring your color guards to present arms.
Colors.
Three,
heads,
arms.
Yeah. I can only hold my stomach in for so long.
Ông đừng đi mà ngoài bà như hồi tướng nha.
Come on, everybody! Hey yo! Hey yo!
Thank you. Oh,
God! Oh, God!
Ta chiến binh sư đoàn nhảy dù từ thôn xóm qua thành đô ra đi qua cơn sơn khê trong gió sương âm thầm nhịp chân sông nước bên nhau sát cánh thiên bài dù gian nguy vẫn không sợ đáng ta chiến binh sư đoàn nhảy dù từ Cà Mau ra miền Trung sông pha tư vững biên cương cùng bốn phương không thể vì dân chiến đấu thì đua sắp xây quê hương vì tự do trong quân tham ta vì lập công riêng thủ và quân anh dũng vang khúc ca lên đường bằng mình hoa đưa đàn người thể hy sinh vẫn tung hoàn cờ đấu tranh ta chiến binh sư đoàn nhảy dù từ thôn xóm qua thành đô ra đi khắp chốn sân khê trong gió sương âm thầm chân sông lớn bên nhau sát cánh thiên vai dù gian nguy vẫn không sợ khan sư đoàn nhảy dù từ Cà Mau ra miền Trung sông pha giữ vững biên cương không bốn phương cầu thể vì dân chiến đấu thì đua đáp xây quê hương vì tự do trong quân tham tàn
biệt ly dân đang ngóng dưới trời gió mưa, làn gió chiều đưa xa nhau bên xưa ngày ấy, anh như bóng mây hồng trôi về chốn xa vời. Vẫn thương lòng ta gió cuốn mây trôi về đâu, cố nén sâu lòng bao năm. Vẫn thương lòng ta gió cuốn mây trôi về đâu, cố nén sâu lòng bao
I just wanted to say thank you for everybody who came and
So this is from the Colonel Reuben H. Tucker chapter and all the other paratroopers that are here today.
Oh, wow.
In Fallujah, Iraq in 2004. We're very proud of a medical training facility at Fort Bragg named after our son and Lieutenant Colonel Mark Taylor, one of the surgeons on his medical team who was killed in the same incident. My wife had a wonderful idea to have these commemorative coins produced in honor of the original dedication. Walter, I'd like to present this one to you. You're an outstanding patriot and great supporter of the Air Force. God bless.
Thank you. Now, I want to take this medic award for combat medic and pass it along to the Doc Drainer, who was our medic in the Dominican Republic and saved a lot of people and is the one responsible, again, for us being here because of his years and years of work to find people. He got me about 6 months after I was released from prison. But anyway, Doc, will you stand up? I want you to give it to Doc. Will you give it to this? He's a combat medic.
There you go. I'm not photogenic and I get it. There we go. More embarrassing for a woman.
Anybody with a movie camera? Whatever.
Okay.
All right, ladies, just press the button. This is a real combat medic. Let me tell you, we served with this guy 54 years ago.
War guns? One more shot. Pendola. You must play Pendola. One shot.
You should take one more.
How about the child arrested for